temple, mosques, and other monuments which bear the testimony of his past glory. It became the center of administration and politics with Nawab Muhammad Hadi Saltanat Khan, afterward known as Mushi Kuli Khan. Mughal Emperor Aurangzeb shifted the office of the Diwan from Dhaka or Jahangirnagar to Maqsudabad in 1701, appointing Mushi Kuli Khan its Diwan. But according to the famous traveler Tiffin Haldun, this town was founded during the reign of Emperor Akbar, and towards a little northwest of the present town, there still exists a mausoleum known as Akbar. In 1594, when Akbar Shahid Khan was the governor of Bengal, his brother Mashum Khan, a merchant and a nobleman who had built a rice, rent house or inns and granaries on the eastern bank of the river Khagera. Even in the first quarter of the 17th century, it became an important center of silk trade throughout India. When the capital of Bengal was shifted from Rajmahal, Akbarnagar, Jahangirnagar, Dhaka, during the governorship of Shesta Khan, Maqsudabad became the residence of the receiver general, and thus the fame of this place started to shine. French traveler Tavernier, who visited this town in 1666, described Maqsudabad as a large town. Gradually, it earned fame, and minting was also done here. Evidence of the coin minting, coin carrying mark of Maqsudabad, bearing the date 1679, is preserved in Lahore Museum. By the first half of the 17th century, Maqsudabad also became famous for trade center, along with its neighboring localities like Bhagwanpola, Kashim Bazar and Jangipur, which were markets for both Indian and foreign traders. Bachocha Port in Bhagwanpola was a major trade port. The second half of the 17th century witnesses the establishment of many European factories at Maqsudabad. In the years 1652-1653, Edward Stephen was sent by the East India Company to establish a silk factory at Kasim Bazar. John Kent was appointed as the chief of the factory. The silk produces of this factory was exported to all over Asia and Europe. Besides this, the Dutch and the French also established their factories respectively at Kalikapur and Forazdama near Kashim. There were innumerable silk winders and expert workmen in Maqsudabad. Hence, Maqsudabad flourished well along before the arrival of Kartalab Khan. But no doubt its glory and fame reached its highest peak in the 18th century, and Kartalab Khan transferred the revenue office of Bengal from Dhaka to Maqsudabad. Emperor Aurangzeb was much pleased with the remittance of the due revenue from Bengal by Kartalab Khan and honored him with the title Mushi Kuli Khan. In 1704, Mushi Kuli Khan renamed this place as Maqsudabad after his own title. From his period, the history of Maqsudabad started taking a new shape, and soon it became a cosmopolitan city. It became so famous that Prince Farrukh Shah came to Maqsudabad and stayed at Lal Bagh for a few years during the early administration of Mushi Kuli Khan. Markets for luxurious items were established for aristocrat and Urdu Bazaar. Rajas, Jamindars and higher officials of the Subah were summoned once in a year by Nawab Mushi Kuli Khan for submitting the revenue in the month of Vaisakh. the first month of the Bengali year. As a result, people from different area and various skill were put to use together here. Thus, it became the nucleus of Eastern India. History says that this place was the epicenter of Indian traders with foreign merchants. Also, many Sufi preachers, saint and scholar came to Murshidabad before the 18th century. Their languages, culture and custom were different. They fraternized freely with the local people, and the outcome of their fraternization resulted in a composite culture. Hence, the culture of the city was further enriched by the Mughal culture. And by mid-18th century, Murshidabad became one of the greatest centers for culture and education in India. In fact, the Nawabs, Rajas and Jamindars contributed wholeheartedly for the development of this new composite culture. This liberal, cosmopolitan, Hindu-Muslim mixed culture is still preciously preserved in some old families of this ancient historic town. Delving deep into the pages of history, we find that the noblemen participated in each annual festivals for Chini. Nawab Nawajid Muhammad Khan, Siraj-ud-Daulah and Mir Zafar Ali Khan used to participate in Holi festival with their Hindu courtiers and such. On such occasion, they used to feed and do charity to the poor of the city. Similarly, many Hindu used to observe and participated in Muslim festivals like Eid and Bari, just as they would during Muharram. Many Nawabs and Rajas, as they were above the religion fanaticism, extended financial help to the shrine of religion other than their own. We can recall that in the Battle of Plassey, Siraj-ud-Daulah was supported by his Hindu officials like Mohanlal and Mirmala, whereas Mir Zafar was supported by Rai Dullab Ram, Omi Chand and Jagat Singh. Hence, there were no place of any religious sentiment, and this is an admitted fact that the Nawabs and their courtiers had helped in hosting a flag of national integration and communal harmony, cultivating a sense of brotherhood among the people. But the gradual decline of Murshidabad's glory and culture started just after shifting our court from Murshidabad to Calcutta in 1772 by Warren Hastings. Many talented personalities left Murshidabad for better prospects. The present decayed town holds old memories laid under the debris of numerous monuments founded centuries ago. This monument still exists in dilapidated condition. The once glorious city of Murshidabad is now in ruins. Scattered throughout the city are the ruins of old palaces, temples, mosques. Even today, the sound of horse and footsteps remind us of all those days. But the gradual decline of royalty and cultural splendor is long gone and permanently so. It is very pleasing to know that the authorities at both state and central level are now need to develop this historic town into fully fledged tourist spot. This will surely attract millions of tourists, which will help in developing this historic town. Thank you.